My name is Raluca Teodorescu, and I implemented self-reflections in the Physics 203 course as part of the SET program. This course is an algebra-based physics course that focuses on motion. Students are non-science majors, about 24 in the classroom, and I implemented self-reflections in two sections of this course in last semester in fall 2018. I must say that before SET started, I did a lot of work on the course, and I designed it as a collection of about 200 problems, conceptual questions, hands-on activities that I categorize according to taxonomies of thinking and offer to students in learning progressions in a way in which, as the semester went on, the students have been exposed to tasks of increasing thinking complexity, but one bit at a time. So this led to low DFW rates and good students' performance, and with the help of self-reflections, I really wanted to look more into this kind of data. So I used anonymous self-reflections, I addressed them after each classroom, and I didn't offer any incentives to try to get as much feedback, not biased, as I could. It is important to mention that in the beginning of the course, in the first week, I explained to students a learning cycle that I developed based on student-related data, a learning cycle that is supposed to make them successful. Before the classroom, I tell them that they have to read and annotate the formula sheet. In the classroom, they have to complete all the tasks, make sure they check their answers, they explain it to one colleague, and after the classroom, they have to read the chapter summary that they prepare, they have to redo the slides and then do the homework and then give themselves a time the exam from everything we've learned. As I said, even I followed the same learning cycle and I discussed it in the first week of classes last semester, but then I followed with self-reflections. Some of them focused on performance, mostly in the beginning of the semester, but then I asked about studying habits, content understanding, course format, performance again towards the end, and in the last self-reflection, I asked the students if they learned something. It is important maybe to mention here that whenever I offered those self-reflections, I explained to students that they are for my learning, for my understanding, for me to help to change the course, until the very last one when I asked about them. In the past, about four semesters before the SET program started, the DFW rates were really just one or two students out of 24 dropping the course, and this was the case for the two sections last semester as well. Regarding the performance, I did hear the class average over four semesters for each of the exams, and you see it's mostly in the A and B region. Now, with a caveat, because I don't use the same exam, so the content is slightly the same, but the exams are not. Pretty much the same within the standard deviation was the situation in fall 2018 as well. So I would say students perform well, but with the help of self-reflections, I wanted to understand this performance better. So I asked in some self-reflections, did you guess on the exams? And I asked after each exam, and after each exam, they said yes. To give you an idea about how many, this is, for instance, the exam two in section one, about 90% of the students answered the question, and pretty much all of them said, that said that they guessed. In section two, about 67 answered, and a significant percent said that they guessed too. Now, this is not too worrisome because they actually, looking at more data, I realized that they guess on one or two problems out of 10. And it's an educated guess because you see the exams are good. So they still know something. But this showed me that good performance does not necessarily mean deep understanding. And I really aim for both in my classes. So after this experience, I really try to test for both or collect data for both. I wanted to document a little bit more and figure out if I can find out why they guess. So in our self-reflections, I asked them, how did you prepare for exam? And this is, for instance, the data for quiz number 2, in which the green area there shows that 13% of the students follow the learning cycle that I mentioned. And the largest percent, 51% orange area, actually review the slides and the homework once. This is data for one section, but the second section looks pretty similar. Again, green area, 16% of the students only follow the learning cycle that I suggest. 31%, orange area, the highest percent, review the homework and the slides once. So I think the students learn the content, but they do not build confidence, or they do not become confident enough to actually trust all their answers. As I mentioned earlier, reflections targeted various aspects, so I got a lot of data and I learned a lot from it. I cannot present it here due to the lack of time. But it's not only me who learned from this. I think students also learned something, because in the last self-reflections, I asked them, list 2 things that you learned about yourself while you completed these self-reflections for me. And I managed to group the students' answers in categories, and I'm going to use students' words to actually illustrate the categories. In section 1, they said, I learned that I have to go over the content multiple times, spend more time studying, pay more attention to my math, and ask for help whenever I'm stuck. So I would say it shows some change in student habits of learning. In section 2, I got a more variety of the answers, but they were still along the same lines. They said that I have to manage my time wisely, make sure I extract the information carefully from the problem before I answer it, review constantly, review the content multiple times, follow the learning cycle that you provided, take notes more carefully, and not be afraid of exams. So again, I feel that the students changed in a good direction as well in the section 2. And I must mention that the sections were very different. In retrospect, I think I learned a lot from self-reflections, and I have a lot of class time in this course, but I also have a lot of content to cover. So I couldn't use class time for anything else. With 5 or 10 minutes, this is what I used here and there in the classroom. I learned a lot. In the future, I want to look carefully at all the data that I mentioned and detail the aspects more in depth. For instance, regarding guessing, I want to look at the characteristics of the problems on which students guessed. Maybe I can address something in the classroom. But overall, I want to continue the wonderful learning experience that I had in the SET program. And it's not only me. You may see my colleagues also enjoyed it very much. So we want to thank Joanne, thank our chairs, our deans, and Dr. Rai, who really made this possible for us. Thank you.